Sveiki! Hello again. I'm glad to be back, and it was quite a long time I didn't make any videos, and I would like to thank you all for watching my channel, for subscribing and liking and sharing, and I'm so happy that you are learning Lithuanian language. And I want to thank you all from United States, from United Kingdom, Lithuania, from Russia, from Brazil, Germany, Ukraine, Belarus, Norway, Ecuador, and actually so many countries I cannot mention all. And it's so exciting when I see that you are learning Lithuanian language in different countries, and thank you for asking questions, for commenting, and when you ask questions and you want to learn more, I want to make more videos for you. So today I'm thinking that we have to focus on basic sentences. I gave you a lot of grammar and it's not all yet, but today let's do something simple and practical. For example, when you meet somebody or you meet somebody again, you want to ask how it's going, how things are going, what's new. So Kas naujo? Kas naujo? Kas naujo means what is new, what's new. Kas naujo? We ask it quite often in Lithuania. Kas naujo? What's new? Or kas šiandien naujo? Kas šiandien naujo? What's new for today? Kas šiandien naujo? O šiandien kas naujo? So we can put words in different way. It doesn't matter the order. Kas naujo? Kas šiandien naujo? Šiandien kas naujo? Kas naujo šiandien? Kas naujo šiandien? Naujas? Naujas, it's new, it's an adjective. Naujas, naujas, naujas rytas, it's a new morning. Nauja diena, naujas, nauja. Naujas for masculine, nauja for feminine. Naujo, naujo, it's a masculine genitive case of masculine. Nieko naujo. Nieko. Nothing. Nieko naujo. It's no news. Nieko naujo. Or you can come to somebody and say, hey, I have some news. Turiu naujienų. Turiu naujienų. It means I have some news. Some news, so genitive case. Ko naujienų. Naujiena. It's news. But in Lithuanian, naujiena, it's singular, not plural. News. Viena naujiena, it's one news. Dvi naujienos, two news. It's feminine. Naujiena, naujienos. Turiu naujienų. I have some news. O yra naujienų. There are some news. Yra naujienų. Nusipirkau naują mašiną. I bought a new car. O nusipirkau naują automobilį. I bought a new car. So this is a good news. Turiu gerą naujieną. I have a good news. Turiu gerą naujieną. Turiu blogą naujieną. Turiu blogą naujieną. I have bad news. Pavėlavau į lėktuvą. I lost my plane. I was late. Pavėlavau. I was late. Pavėlavau į lėktuvą. Pavėlavau į darbą. I was late to my work. Pavėlavau. It's a bad news. If you ask kas naujo, what's new? Or in another way, you can ask kokios naujienos? What kind of news? Kokios naujienos? What kind of news? Kokios naujienos? Or you can ask kas gero? What's good? Kas gero? Kas gero? What's good? Nieko gero? Nothing good. Nieko gero. And in Lithuanian, if you ask kokios naujienos, kas naujo, kas gero, it means you want to know what is going in somebody's life. Kas gero? Viskas gerai. All is good. Kas gero? Turiu idėją. What's good? I have an idea. Kokia idėja? Oh, what kind of idea? Tell me. Kokia idėja? Kas naujo? What's new? Suradau naują darbą. Suradau naują darbą. O, radau naują darbą. O, gavau naują darbą. Suradau naują darbą. I found a new work. I found a new job. Radau naują darbą. I found a new job. Gavau naują darbą. I got a new job. So now we know how to ask and we know how to answer. And when somebody says, when you ask, kas gero? Nusipirkau naują mašiną. I bought a new car. And you say, o, nuostabu. O, o, it's wow. Now Lithuanians, they started using the expression wow as well. But you have to know that it's not, originally it's not Lithuanian. In Lithuanian it would be o, 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 puiku, o, nuostabu, o, labai gerai, puiku, wonderful, nuostabu, wonderful, labai gerai, very good. Džiaugiuosi. I'm glad for you. Džiaugiuosi. I'm glad. I'm rejoicing. I'm glad. Džiaugiuosi. If your friend is ill, you say gaila. Gaila, it's sad. Gaila, it's sad. Shame. Shame. And this word shame for Lithuanians, it's in Lithuanian, shame is gėda. But if you find it, this word, if you translate this word and you use it instead gaila, if you will say gėda, it will not work. Because when you say shame in English, it's okay, it's like, it's sad. But in Lithuanian, shame, it means shame on you, shame. If somebody says, I'm ill, sergu, sergu, I'm ill, and you say shame, it means shame on you. And yeah, maybe it's shame on you that you are ill. Maybe you did something wrong. You became ill. Okay, gaila, sad. That's sad, gaila. It's a pity. Sad, actually, literally, sad, it's liūdna. Liūdna. Liūdna, it's maybe more stronger word. If somebody died, you say liūdna, it's sad. And gaila, it's a pity. Yeah. Okay, I think that's it for today. And I'm really glad we can continue with Lithuanian and I can't promise, but I will do my best with continuing teaching you, giving you lessons. And please subscribe, like, support, and send me comments, please. Iki.